that, buddies. Thought I'd show you what I do whenever I paint a face on a cowl. Most people would think, oh, you tape it off and you spray it. Well, you could do that. You know, if you just use like the impressionist approach, it's very simple. I don't allow my cowls to go out with these faces in them. I worry that somebody might not take them out and put it on and suffocate. I wouldn't want to take a chance on that. So what you could do is have a face and you could paint it, stick it back in a cowl without a face. But a lot of times I'll leave a cowl, my own personal collection, with the face in it. I think, well, I don't care. I'll just leave them up and whatever. I'm not really a stickler for having everything perfect. I'm always in a constant state of flux. So what I do is I take some acrylic paint and a little palette and some brushes. And I just mix up some dark tones for the flesh color. I always use blue, red, white, black, and yellow. I don't go by flesh color. One of the things we learn in art school is the flesh and the way that lights hit it and things like that. It really isn't just flesh color. It's got all kinds of stuff going on in it. And so I like to have fun because this is just for me. So it's like art for art's sake. You know, I'm artsy one, but sometimes I do artsy fartsy stuff. Artsy fartsy stuff. If it's just for me, that's as close as I get to doing artsy fartsy stuff. I've got this mostly to where I want it to be already. I'm just kind of showing you how I go about doing it. Once I got the dark tones on there, I'll come in and I'll kind of dry brush. Dry brush kind of means, you know, put a little bit on the brush, wipe it off, make sure it's not a lot of moisture. I'll kind of just move the brush over it, over some of the areas, and let the texture below kind of rub off the paint a little bit. Just let it catch a few highlights here and there. Really dry. It just gives a more modulated feeling, like there's more going on. And I just feel that's more effective than just an overall flat spraying of a flesh color. I've got this darkened down a little bit just so you can see what I mean. And it's fun. You can't go wrong, because if you mess up, just do it over again. Think of it as an impressionist painting. That's what I do. Just work with the dry brush until you get some things that you like. For the eyes, I just switch to a smaller brush. And I just sketch them in there. Because it's going to give the illusion that it's real, you know, from the distance, from the shadows. And don't be too hard on yourself. That takes about 10, 15 minutes to do something like that. It looks like it's a little modulated, like skin would be. Maybe after he comes in from one of his nights out. But instead of just looking like it's taped off and just sprayed with a uniform flesh color, each little face is kind of like its own little work of art. 10, 15 minutes and you're done. So that's what I do anyway.